my name is Brennan Conry. I am an academic advisor in the Faculty of Engineering. Today, I'm going to show you how to calculate your grade point average or your GPA in a step-by-step process. So we'll go over the calculations as well as a couple different scenarios that you might want to consider when calculating your GPA. So what I'm going to just go through in these couple slides is what is a grade point at McMaster? So breaking down what a grade is and how to convert it into a point. What is a unit, which is very important when calculating your GPA. The actual process in calculating your GPA. And then a couple different scenarios that you might want to consider, which would affect your GPA, such as the repeat rule or using a non-numerical grade. Additionally, for this term, you do have the option for a pass or no credit for your winter 2020 grades. So at the end of this presentation, I'll go over how you can calculate your GPA if you are considering using that policy. So at McMaster, we have a 12-point grade scale, which is associated with the letter grade you receive for a course. So in this chart, you can see from F, which is associated with a zero in the equivalent grade point, all the way to a 12, which is equal to an A plus. So this middle column here of equivalent grade point is what we're going to be using when calculating your GPA. Units. So each course has an associated amount of units. And what is important with this is using this to be weighted for your GPA when we're calculating it. So for example, we're gonna be using three different courses for our calculation. So Chem 1 EO3, Engineer 1 DO4, and Japanese 1 Z06. So the last number of these courses indicates the amount of units per course. You wouldn't want to use calculating your GPA for the sake of dividing it by the amount of courses, because some courses with bigger weights are weighted more for your GPA. So the actual calculation. So you can do this in Excel if you are wanting to calculate your GPA or look at some possible scenarios of what your final grades would look like in different cases. So for our example, we're going to just use three courses and they're displayed right here. So the first thing you want to do is indicate the courses and then pull the actual letter grade you have per course. Okay, so for example, we have Chem 1 EO3 with a B. And then what you want to do is take that letter grade and convert it to the previous chart, which we had for the equivalent point grade. So for a B, that is an 8. For a C minus, that is a 4. And for an A plus, that is a 12. For the following column, we actually want to indicate the units per course. So again, for Chem 1 EO3, that would be 3 units, 1 DO4, 4 units, 1 Z06, 6 units. So now that you have all of that information and data in place, what you're actually going to do is calculate the amount of points per course that you got a grade in. So what you do is you multiply the grade by the units to get your point. So for example, Chem 1 EO3, we multiply 8 by 3 units, that gets us 24 points. So the next step, what you do is for all your courses, you sum up your points. So for this calculation, we have a total of 112 points and 13 units. So now the final step is to actually divide your total points by the amount of units you have. So that way your distribution of weighted courses is even by units and not by course. You wouldn't want to divide this by three courses because there are different weighted units per course. So again, what we have here is a total of an 8.6 GPA. Now to go over some different scenarios you want to consider if you have taken different courses. We have a repeat rule at McMaster. So if you are repeating a course, the previous attempt of the course is actually removed from your GPA calculation. This rule came into effect in fall 2018. So if your first attempt that you are retaking was taken before the fall 2018, unfortunately, it doesn't follow in this policy. However, if you've taken a course since the fall 2018 and then have since repeated it, that attempt is now removed and your new attempt is put in the GPA solo. So for the example, we'll use the same courses, but in this scenario, I've indicated that Chem 1 EO3 was taken in the fall of 2019, and this student, hypothetical student, received an F. Okay, so that is going into their GPA at this time. And as you can see, their GPA with our calculations is now a 6.8. So in following up, the student now has retaken Chem 1 EO3 in the following fall, so fall of 2020, has now achieved a letter grade of A. So now the previous attempt is removed from the GPA calculation and the new attempt is put in on its own. Again, just to reiterate, if the student had taken this course in the fall of 2017, that course would still remain in the GPA. But now since the student has repeated it, the GPA is now upgraded to a 9.3. Non-numerical grades. So when you are calculating your GPA and if you have a non-numerical grade, we actually want to remove that as part of the calculation. So examples of non-numerical grades that are common for undergraduate students would be courses that you took on a letter of permission or LOP, where you would be receiving a T for a transfer or an NC for no credit. Similarly, if you took a personal interest course or a PIC course at McMaster, you would be getting a CR for credit or an NC for no credit. Again, these courses aren't used in the GPA, so I'll show you in the next demonstration how that would look. So the courses as displayed here show that the Chem 1 EO3 and Engineer 1 DO3 are letter grades, but this student opted to do a PIC course for their Japanese 1Z06. So they received the credit for the course, a non-numerical grade, but we aren't using that in our GPA calculation. So as you can see, there is no grade or units to use as part of this GPA calculation. So the GPA is a 5.7. Again, the course does show up on your transcript just as the non-numerical grade. But again, we aren't using this because there is no grade to associate for the GPA. So now we're going to go over the past no credit grading scheme that students have the option of using for the winter 2020 term. You do have this option to use for any of your winter term courses where you would be converting a graded course to a non-numerical grade. This is just different because you are declaring this after you've received your grade. And this is a one-time option. So I'll just go through a scenario of what it would look like if you wanted to see what your GPA would look like if you are converting a graded course to a pass or no credit. So similar to the calculation of a non-numerical grade, we have our grades posted here as a final winter 2020 term. So for example, Chem 1 EO3, Engineer 1 DO4 and Japanese 1Z06, we all have letter grades for these courses for right now for the winter, but maybe we are trying to decide if we should convert any of these courses to a pass. So currently right now, what we would be looking at is doing our regular calculations and at our current state, we have an 8.6 average. However, if we wanted to convert one of those courses, we simply would be removing the letter grade with a P. Since the grade that you received was a passing grade, you would get a P for pass. And since we are using a non-numerical grade, the grade and units are removed from our calculation. So now our GPA has actually gone up to a 10.7. On the flip side of this, if we wanted to convert a course to a no credit because you received a failing grade, we would then demonstrate how that would look here. So if the course you received an F for is bringing your average down. So in this scenario, our GPA calculations have shown we are at a 3.1 and that F might be really bringing us down because it's providing 0 points for our total sum of the calculation. We may want to consider using the no credit option for this. So now that we've actually removed the F from the calculation and placed an NC, our average has actually gone up to a 5.7. So this is just another scenario in terms of how you would want to calculate the different options you have for converting courses to a no credit. So that concludes our different scenarios for calculating the GPAs. If you would like to find out more information about the pass and no credit policy, please visit the registrar's link below. It will also give you instructions on how to submit a pass no credit request if you wish to. For more information about the Academic Advising Office, if you have further questions, please follow the Academic Advising link below to connect with your academic advisor. Stay safe. Good luck.